Breeders' Cup World Championships coming to Old Del Mar Friday and Saturday, November 1st and 2nd. We continue along with our Contenders videos. We've already got running styles up for the Breeders' Cup Classic. A look at some of the Japan-based runners. Smash that like button. Today we're going to talk about Future Stars Friday and all the Euros coming over from the UK and Ireland for the Breeders' Cup. Lots of runners, Future Stars Friday. Of course, that's when all the two-year-olds run at the Breeders' Cup. We're going to have horses from Canada, Ireland, the UK, and also horses represented in the Juvenile Turf Sprint, the Juvenile Turf, and the Juvenile Fillies Turf. As many three races, there could be as many as 17 to 20 runners from the Ireland, UK, Kansas, all coming on over to take over the best of the American runners. Let's start off with some of the contenders in the Juvenile Turf Sprint. We're going to start off with Austerius. He won the Flying Childress Stakes. Now, this was a grade two. What was nice about this effort is he defeated Big Mojo. Now, those two horses have ran against each other a couple of times. In the Juvenile Turf Sprint, it was Austerius getting the win. Overall, he's got four wins in six starts. He was second in a group three race. He was a winner by a neck in the group two in the Flying Childers. Austerius coming over, got that European pedigree and should be strong in the turf. Now, Big Mojo was second to Austerius. That was in the Flying Childers Stakes. But let's go back earlier this summer. Big Mojo defeated Austerius in the group three Molcombe Stakes. And this one, Big Mojo kind of got the jump, kind of took that advantage. You know, again, the bigger fields over in the Europe in some of these turf races, especially in these early on stakes races, as they have a much shorter racing season and they get going right away. So Big Mojo defeated Austerius in that Molcombe Stakes. Another Juvenile Turf Sprint runner is Gabaldon. He was a winner at Ascot. Let's go to this one. Second in the Windsor Castle Stakes. What was interesting about this race, there was 27 horses. You see the big group on the outside, a group of horses on the inside. Gabaldon finished second at Ascot. Traditionally a strong meet. It's only a five-day meet in June. Good horses travel over there. 27 horse field. Gabaldon finishing second. Another runner was Magnum Force. Magnum Force, a maiden win in a 14-horse field, kind of powered away late, kind of not as demanding of a course. This was more of a straightaway type race with Magnum Force picking up that win. What I like, he's got a little bit of experience now, and these horses have been in training a little bit longer than some of the American horses, so they seem to be a little bit more fit, even for this sprint race, and that can come into play. Now, Magnum Force, overall, four starts, one win, 2 seconds. His win, of course, that maiden win. Then he went into the Grave Roses Stakes, and then he was third to Austerius and Big Mojo in that Flying Childers Stakes. Now, Shareholder, another one, ran at Ascot, the Norfolk Stakes. Again, Ascot, small meet, lots of horses, big fields, and usually you get some well-meant horses for that meet. Shareholder winning that Norfolk Stakes. That's been a good precursor to some of these juvenile races the last couple of years over here in the Breeders' Cup. It's been a little bit of a key race at Norfolk Stakes. Shareholder by Not This Time. Of course, he's in a U.S.-based sire. And overall, three starts, two wins for Shareholder. Won that Norfolk Stakes, a group two. And then he also had a win first time out back in June. So back-to-back wins in June, and then last time out ran in a grade one race in France, finishing off the board. Now, Star of Mamus, interesting horse, 3 for 4. Let's go to the synthetic. This was a nice maiden win, powered away late. Star of Mamus getting that win. Then they put him back on the lawn, the Roseberry Stakes. That was a listed stakes for Star of Mamus. 3 wins and 4 starts. Looks like a smaller filly and one to be keeping an eye on for the Breeders' Cup at Del Mar. Now, the Juvenile Filly Turf, we've got Shantae. She won the listed Ingabell Stakes. Look at her. She's in the green all over the track kind of late. Boy, kind of a small filly too. Look at her, kind of a petite pocket rocket. But She kind of floated inside, floated outside. They straightened her out. Hopefully she improves as she comes over here. Sean T winning that Ingabell Stakes. And Shoda going to come over for Team Valor, winning the William Hill Group 3, wearing the pink. Bust through late. This was a rainy day. You see all the umbrellas and kind of foggy. But and Shoda powering away late in the pink on that soft course. Course at Del Mar, it's going to be fast, firm, and won't be as much given the course. So some of the Euros will like this firm course at Del Mar. Some of them, and Shoda, I question, can she win on a firm course as easily as she did on that Group 3 in the reigning soft course for and Shoda. Now, the odds for the Juvenile Turf Sprint, we've got Asturias at 9-2, Big Mojo at 5-1. They've shared wins together. Ikoro Sieg from Japan, course record last time out, 6-1. And then Shareholder at 12-1. I think you could be see as many as five horses under 10-1 in that Juvenile Turf Sprint. That will probably be a 13-14 horse field. Now, we got a racing picks and notebooks coming out for both Breeders' Cup Friday and Saturday. Sign up once, you're good to go. If you've already signed up, you'll get the picks. Top three picks in each of the races for the Breeders' Cup delivered after the scratches. Also, we've got the sprint running styles up, dirt mile running styles, and the classics. Make sure to watch those. A video on the Japan runners and the Breeders' Cup now just inside, 8 days away as we get you ready for more Breeders' Cup action. Channel memberships available, some exclusive content coming up next week, and the tip jar is open. Thanks for your support, and smash that like button, share, and share with your friends for all these videos. And remember, as we look ahead, the best chances for the Euros in 2024, who are you liking in some of these races? Leave a comment, share, and like as we get you ready. Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.